everybody. Welcome to another episode of Q&A Thursdays with your hosts, Jeffrey Whitlock and Keith Mitchell. Happy to be here again. Keith, how's it been going?
Good. A little technical trouble this afternoon with my phone. Maybe the new screen's not all like it was cracked up to be.
You know, we were really excited for your new phone and all of the glory and everything that it would be on, and it has really let me down today.
Maybe I need a new phone.
Maybe you need a new phone, Keith. That's all I'm saying. But we do have a new piece of technology with us today. On this phone that we're recording, we have a brand new microphone.
Yes.
On it. So hopefully you can hear us all better. If you cannot hear us very well, too bad.
We'll try to speak louder.
Yeah. No, send us a post and we'll try and speak louder. And, you know, we're just working on some of these technical things so we can make all of these lives the best that they can be.
Yes. Practice makes perfect.
Practice makes perfect. I like it, Keith. That's exactly what it is. I like it. Okay, so I'm going to try and jump on here so we can get your comments. But just like every week, we're going to answer all of your questions. So start sending those in now, and we'll try and get to every single one of them. All right, let's see who we've got on here real quick. I've got Anthony Trammell coming in loud and clear. Thank you, Anthony. Do you think it's better than before? Hopefully it should be better. Because I spent a lot of money. I'm just kidding. I didn't. No. Just kidding. That's just kidding. Bob Dreyer, hey Bob, glad to see you. He says he can hear us just fine. Stephen Cross, hey. Greg Justice, thanks everybody for watching. We're glad to have you here.
Oh, definitely.
Is there anything else that we've got people? We're in the back lot of the Mud Buddy headquarters, and we've got a lot of action. We got people going out, people coming in. It's crazy out here. But send in those questions. Keith, what else has been going on this week while we're waiting for everybody to kind of hop on and get with us?
I had a nice Memorial Day weekend. You know, yeah. I think I showed my age a little bit, took the kids to the lake on Monday, and just can't do on a set of skis or a knee board or wakeboard that I used to do, and woke up Tuesday morning wishing I wouldn't have to show the kids what I used to be able to do.
Where are those pictures, Keith? That's what I want to know.
No pictures, bro.
Come
no
on,
pictures.
Man. Oh, man.
Well, a lot of ibuprofen over the last couple days.
Jimmy Parrish, hello from Mississippi.
Hey,
Jimmy.
Mississippi. How's the weather there?
Yeah,
hot, humid?
Oh, I bet you it's so humid out there. Plus the hurricane.
Yeah.
It's kind of moving on through that area. So, you know, stay safe. Stay safe, everybody.
So that was kind of like my weekend. What did you cruise around and do?
You know, I really didn't do too much. I kind of spent a lot of time at home. I did get a little barbecue with the family.
There
that
you
was
go.
Nice.
That's always nice.
Yeah. Burgers and chips, really, is what we did. It was awesome. Yeah. Actually, it was really nice. We had a nice four-day weekend, so it was really good.
It was.
So we have a lot to get to today. We want to get to all of your questions, but before we do that, we have a lot of some big announcements. I put big announcements all over the thing. I've been planning this, working toward this for a long time, but before we even get to that, hold you all in suspense. Do you remember last time we were here? There are a couple of things. First off, we have Jody back with us holding the camera. So everybody, big shout out to Jody. Thank you so much for holding this camera for us. We appreciate you taking the time out of your day because, yeah, it's hot out here, man. It is really hot out here.
It's still warm, I'm thinking. I hope it cools down by October
6th. Oh, my gosh. I mean, and there's no water here, so it's not like the birds have anywhere to learn to land anyway. Also, last time you were showing people, we were over there, and you were showing people that cutoff switch.
Yes.
You know what we were talking about? And people were like, oh, that would be the best.
Right.
The best practical joke to play on somebody. And we were like, yes, send us in your videos. We want to see it happen.
I definitely want to see it happen.
I really want to see it happen. And how many videos did we get?
Zero.
Big old goose egg, everybody.
Oh, come on, guys.
Failed me. So we're still looking for those. I have prizes for anybody who sends those in. I want
to
see.
Maybe we have to step it up, the prizes a little bit
Maybe
more.
We do. Maybe we do.
I'm not saying this could be one of them.
We're not saying that this is one of them. I'm not saying that it's not one of them.
Right.
What I'm saying is that I haven't seen a single one, and I really, really want to see it. So tell them again what it actually happens, what
so
it is.
It's a little cutoff switch, a breaker that we put onto the battery cable, and then it connects to the battery. So you can disconnect it and cut the power to your motor when you're just storing it. Or when you're out in the marsh, dad, your buddies, whatever it is, isn't paying attention. You flip the switch, you kill the power, they don't notice it, and then you anticipate what's going to happen. Whether it's
as they scramble around looking for the reason, why is it broken? They start to call Keith, and everybody's crying. It's really awesome. That's what I want to see. I want to see some hysterics.
I definitely want to see them.
Yes. So we're really looking for those videos. Send those in. I have big prizes for any videos that come in because I really want. I think it'll be the funniest. Now it's the big moment.
The big moment?
It's the big moment, Keith. We've been waiting for this for a long time. So we're almost to the, in a couple of weeks, it will be exactly 1 year that we've been doing Q&A Thursdays. We're at our 1 year mark. So we're about to start season two of Q&A Thursdays. But we thought, in honor of doing this, because it's been so successful, because all of you have watched the show, have stuck with us, and have helped out in all sorts of different ways, that we're going to kind of revamp just a little bit. We're rebranding. Just
rebranding a little bit?
Yes.
Or a lot?
Kind of a lot, actually.
Kind of a lot.
But don't worry. Jesus. The most important part is that we are keeping the Q&A forum.
Gotcha.
So you'll be able to still do that. So don't worry about that. But what we are changing, first and foremost, we're changing the name.
What are we changing?
We're going to change the name. Do you want to say it? Do you want
me
to say it?
No, go ahead. I'm going to let you do it. I know you've been dying. And we've
been
holding you back, saying, Jeffrey, not today.
All right, not
today.
Today's the day. Okay, so I'm going to tell you what we've decided to call it. We are going to officially be known as Shallow Water Adventures with Keith and Jeffrey. That's what we're calling it. It's nothing groundbreaking. It's very what it is. But welcome to the shallow water, everybody. Hey. You're in the shallow water with Keith and Jeffrey. We're really excited. That's what we're going to call it from here on out. So when you see it, come across your Facebook page, the Shallow Water Adventures with Keith and Jeffrey. It's this.
And this,
Jeff,
is what it is. You've done a really nice job on that logo.
Thank you.
We've been battling back and forth.
Man.
I can't say battling. Discussions and changes and getting a few other people.
Because we want it to look amazing. We've got a brand new look. We've got a new logo. Because, you know, maybe I might wear my own t-shirt one day instead of this beautiful Tangle Free shirt.
Tangle Free.
I know.
Why are you wearing a Tangle Free shirt?
Well, I'm going to get to that, Keith.
Okay.
Funny you should mention that very thing. As we start season two, which will begin on the 20th, be Wednesday, which is another big thing that we're changing. We are officially moving from Thursdays to Wednesdays. So it will be every week on Wednesdays. We've done that for several reasons, none of which I will get into now, but just know that it will be on Wednesdays coming up. So every Wednesday, we will have the Shallow Water Adventures with Keith and Jeffrey. But because we're starting season two, we've been talking to all of our good friends, our sponsors, and we have an incredible lineup of prizes to give away. This has been, we have boxes and boxes.
My office is overrunning.
Free
stuff.
Free stuff.
Free stuff.
Of our sponsors, all of these incredible companies have pitched in for this new season, because we want to make it so big. And we've got, of course, it's all my logo.
It's
really
logo.
What it is.
It's all the
That's
logo.
Why. Brandon Webb, you're in the shallow water. Brandon, you are officially in the shallow water, my friend. So this is really big, and I'm going to tell you some of these names.
Okay.
One, of course, being Tangle Free right here. They have given a ton of stuff. We're really excited.
And you know, their stuff, it's Sitka.
Yeah.
So they've got the Sitka.
Oh, yeah.
They've got the Sitka Tangle Free stuff with the Optifade and the timber camo patterns on the stuff that we have.
Oh, man.
You know what? I just have to leave it in there because it's for you guys.
For you guys.
Not for me.
We're not taking any of it home.
We're not taking it home.
You are wearing a shirt from one of our sponsors.
I am wearing one. Echo Calls.
Echo Calls, man. They've sent in some good stuff. Some really, really good stuff. We've got stuff from Lucky Duck. We've got stuff from Deep Apparel, which is really exciting. We've got some brand new stuff coming in from Deep. Stuff from Swift Water. We've got an incredible prize from Camp Chef.
Camp Chef has
stepped up. We just love those guys. And of course, our good friends just across town, BPS, has some really amazing stuff. And there's probably even more. Like, we're still talking
we're
to several.
We're still talking to
the
a
ink
few
isn't
more
quite dry on a
nope.
couple of contracts. So, but guys, we have amazing prizes for every week. So, season two, the official season two, will run for 20 weeks.
20 weeks.
That's what we've done, right? 20 weeks will be the official season. So that will cover all of duck season and well into the beginning of fishing season next year. So we're really excited about that. So for all of you joining us back again, I apologize so much. I've never seen that happen. We were standing out there talking in the heat, and the iPhone overheated.
It said bye.
I'm out. I can't handle this anymore. I'm dead. I would rather die than be here, is what it said. So I apologize. Thank you all for sticking with us. For everybody out there, and we forget this every week, but I always want to remind everybody, please subscribe and follow us. Follow and share is what we really love when you do. That helps us out a lot.
It does.
So if you're watching this on Facebook right now and you aren't following Facebook, You should definitely do that now. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the subscribe button and hit the little bell next to it. That's right next to the subscribe button. That way you'll be notified every time we put up a new video, and you'll never miss a single second of this guy.
You'll always be with us.
Always be with us. Always. Never be apart. The reason we were out there to begin with is that something kind of crazy happened.
It wasn't crazy.
It wasn't crazy.
It was kind of sad.
I was sad. So I was really sad. So there was a rumor. A rumor went around that they were going to sell our marketing boat, like our test boat that we run and we do all of our video.
The one that we enjoyed for the last
year. Pretty much a year we've had that boat. And last week it happened. They sold it. Somebody bought that boat. So there's a lucky person out there enjoying our boat.
Keith. Yes, he's enjoying our Excel F86 with our 44 EFI. Going to be running around the marshes of Utah.
Yes, in a famous boat.
In a famous boat.
Yes.
But that's okay. I was a little depressed, a little hurt.
I was a little sad.
But, man, Jeff, what they showed us.
Oh, my gosh.
It kind of went away really
quick. I know. It happened all so fast. But the boat we were standing in front of is our new boat. They got us a new boat, everybody. We have a brand new 1754 Pro Hull. F86 Pro Hull.
Big, wide, will hold all of our gear.
This boat is going to be so sick, everybody. I'm really excited. It's the only thing that made me feel better about this whole little situation. But we've got a brand new boat. And what we want to do in honor of getting this new boat is that we want to name this boat.
We want to name it.
So we are going to do a competition, a little giveaway competition. I want to hear names. I want your suggestions of what we should call this boat. And whatever name we pick, we're going to give away a hat. Just kidding. We're going to give away a big blade prop.
The coveted big blade prop.
Whoever's name we pick. So I want you in this thread or on, if you're watching it on YouTube later on, put in the comments what you think we should call the boat. And the one that we pick is getting a big blade.
And we're going to do that on?
That is going to happen on our opening day on the 20th. Of September, so in 2 weeks is when we will announce that.
And we want cool, really cool.
Yeah, cool names. Don't call anything stupid or mean.
We're not
looking
for the USS Minnow because there's only two of us and not a whole crew.
I mean, so, yeah, something cool. But like, you know, not like laser blaster or something. I don't know.
Yeah,
something awesome. The bald eagle.
There we go. That would be a good one.
That seems appropriate.
Yeah,
so we're okay with.
You can't win the prop though.
Yeah, well, I can't win the prop.
And you can't use that name now because Jeff gave that out to you.
I don't know. Somebody could, I guess.
Maybe,
I don't know.
Yeah. We'll
maybe.
See.
I mean, I thought it was appropriate. But, yes, so that's our big thing going on for the next 2 weeks. Send in your name suggestions. And we're gonna name that boat. We've got a lot of cool stuff to go into it. We've got a new dry bag going into it. We've got the gun box that's going to go into it that's specific to it. We've got a few other modifications, but we're going to try and show those as they kind of put it together. Right now, it's just out on blocks. It doesn't have the motor. It doesn't have a trailer. It's not on the trailer. But as they do that, I'm going to take pictures and video and stuff so you get to see the process.
Yeah, we gave up our 44 EFI, which was a great running motor, but what do we get now, Jeff?
I don't know.
We're going to get the big new HDR 50 horsepower 5000.
So I tell you,
we thought we were scooting across the water.
We
before.
Did think we were scooting across the water.
Now we're going to be scooting the water in style with our Pro Hull. And I'm excited for that because I just love that big open floor plan.
Yeah, you really do, which is awesome. It really is going to be a sweet boat. We're going to move.
And the driver's seat, it's an Orca ice chest.
It's an Orca ice chest, so we can keep our
beverages
in there.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. So it's awesome. We're also turning over a new leaf, like we said last time. We've got brand new life jackets. Season 2, everybody. It's going to be crazy.
It's crazy.
All right. So now that that's all done, let's get to some of the questions. I almost wish I had another phone because we had a lot of questions coming in on
other feed.
So if we don't get to your questions, we will be on that other feed as well, trying to answer everybody's questions on this.
So you mentioned what size boat it was, wasn't it?
I did say it.
So I think whoever comments back what size boat it is, we're going to give them one of these cool new Sitka hats. And because it's an Excel boat,
It's got the Excel logo. I just borrowed these from Dave Reynolds, the Excel boat guy. So
yes,
he was.
These are brand new. Yes,
more than willing to donate those. And it's the, what do they call it, trucker style?
Yeah, it's a trucker hat.
Yeah, trucker hat.
Flat brim trucker hat. And because we are young and we are hip and we are awesome.
Okay, some of us are young.
You are not as young as I am.
I am not young, but that's okay.
I am not as hip as you are.
Yeah, well, I'm not really hip at all. But so anybody who throws at us what that was, the first person
yes,
to comment.
What the boat is. Do you want the whole boat or just the size of the
boat? I just want the size.
You want the size.
I don't care that all you right. tell me it's an F-86. Blankety blank blank. I know what it is. So, do we have a winner yet?
We do. We've got a bunch.
We got a bunch. Now.
We'll get to that. Okay. I want to get into the questions now that people have. Questions. So I want to get.
Now
see.
I'm starting to sweat.
I know. I am so hot, everybody. Oh, we've got Daryl Newman, the Waterfowl Company, is here.
Hey
guys.
How are you?
How's it going today from Joe DeCrane? Hey, Joe. And then Trammell's back on. He stayed on. Very good.
Thanks for staying with us. You know, technical difficulties.
Oh, man. Just happens kind of every time.
A little frustrating, but it makes life exciting.
Oh, Sydney wants us to send that big blade to Mississippi. Sydney, I want some good names then.
You get us the right name,
get
Sydney.
Us the right
and
name.
This big blade, which I kind of think it's really, I think it's Mud Buddy's most versatile all around
oh,
blade
yeah.
for any motor you can use.
Oh, absolutely. So, I'm a big fan of the big blade.
It's a nice covered prop.
Yeah, absolutely. And all of our props are really excellent. They spend a lot of time perfecting these props, which is really excellent.
And it's free. This one's free.
And it's free.
And it's free.
If for the right name.
Yes, for the right name.
Okay, let's see. Oh, we've got a Taylor Hoover, first time tuning in.
Hey, Taylor. Welcome to Q&A Thursday.
Taylor.
We have to wait till 2 weeks before we can study the new stuff, can't we?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, we got it. But she says, my boyfriend has a new boat coming. That hat would look great with the boat.
Well.
You would. It would. It really would. That's awesome. Anthony Trammell, those pro holes are the cat's meow.
I'm thinking so. I can't wait to get it. We're going to have to put a little pressure on the guys downstairs to get that thing rolling. Maybe I'll recruit one of our lead tech, Enrique, see if he can sneak out there every once in a while and put some of the stuff in it, some of the extra stuff.
Some of the extra stuff.
We have the ability to add to that boat. So.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so I do have to do one shout out from Dustin Everett with his name suggestion, just because he says the Bandit.
The Bandit.
In honor of Burt Reynolds.
Oh, yes.
Burt Reynolds passed away today.
I heard that.
Yeah. So that's actually a really great name suggestion, and maybe in our hearts, if we don't choose that name, maybe in our hearts.
There we go.
We will remember Burt Reynolds
as the
Bandit.
I think that would be a good tattoo for you, Jeff. Okay, we're not going there.
Right on the side.
Right on the
whatever,
side.
I'm going to do it just like the XL patch
right
on the side of
these
hats. I'm going to just do XL right on the side of my head so I don't ever have to wear a hat. Oh, man, we've got some... Okay, so, yeah... there are so many good ones in here, you guys. This is awesome.
So now we're going to have our work cut out for us.
Okay, so Michael Brown says, can I trade my GTR for a Mud Buddy? It is terrible. Yes. I don't know about trade. I don't know how any of all that works. You'd have to maybe call in and ask, but boy, I feel you.
Or find your local Mud Buddy dealer.
Yeah, maybe they can help you out, but I feel your pain. No, that's awesome. We want you to have a Mud Buddy.
We would love you to have a Mud Buddy.
All right, so the first person that posted the correct answer, you ready for this?
Yes.
Like, ease your heartbeat, and nobody really cares. No, Matt Cowell, our good friend, who is on just about every week. So congratulations, Matt. Yes, 1754.
Correct.
That's what it is.
And it looks bigger than that.
It does look bigger than that. Well, it's wide open. It's a beautiful boat.
So we're one hat down, but oh. Maybe we'll have to come up with another question.
Another question.
For hat number two.
Yes. Okay, Dylan Jones, when's the new building being built for XL boats? Really good question. So that plant, the new plant that will be in Tennessee, is scheduled to be opened next March, is what the schedule says. But, you know, things always happen. So when that will actually happen, I don't know, but stay tuned for that. We keep a lot of updates going on that, and they are going to, which I'm really excited about. Jay Paul, our good buddy, who should be watching and is probably not because he's in trouble.
Yes.
He is going to do time-lapse of the building of that building. So we're going to get to see the whole thing kind of be created over time.
Talking to him yesterday, what did he say that thing was like 500 and something feet long?
It's massive.
It's like a 100,000 square foot building. And I couldn't imagine trying to put a shop together and where you need to make everything flow the way you want it to flow. So good luck, Jay Paul.
Luckily, those guys are smart. We've got a lot of really brilliant people working on it.
Really good. So that's about all we can tell you.
Yes.
If we told you any more, we'd probably get killed.
Right? Okay, Jeff Warner, can you turn the big blade if you're only turning 4,300 RPM?
Oh, yeah. That's no problem.
Yeah.
4,300 RPM on a big blade is a good RPM.
Right.
So, yeah, no problem. Big blade is pretty much, up until we came out with the three blades, that was our standard. I've been here since 2006. And
that's... you're like 100.
I'm like 100.
You're like 100.
Yes, and getting older every year. So that's been our standard prop as long as I've been around.
Yeah.
Some of the new 40s and the new 50s are going out with that new three blade, which is an amazing great prop, the Raptor. So, but yeah, the big blade, 4,300 RPM on that one's a great prop.
Yeah.
It'll push you well.
Yeah. Absolutely. Let's see. Jeff and Jarrett at M&M Marine. Say hi.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Jeff and Jarrett.
Hey, we remember you guys. Didn't you guys come here to Mud Buddy like a couple winters ago?
Did they?
I took them up to Park City.
Awesome.
Got a little extra special treatment.
Wow.
And we saw a big old cow moose and her calf about, maybe 20 yards away.
Yeah.
So pretty cool. Just be bopping along there. We were up at the, what do I want to call that? The Olympic Park area. We were up there.
Oh, yeah.
The Olympic Park. The Olympic Park. Which is an amazing place. More fun during the summer than the winter because I'm not much of a snow skier.
Uh-huh.
Tons of stuff to do during the summer.
But you water ski. Why don't you snow ski?
You really
this
want to know
Utah.
Why?
Yes.
You know heights. I do not.
Okay.
If I didn't have to ride that stupid lift and people bouncing on and hanging off the edge, no. I can't do it just because of that. I know it's kind of silly, huh?
That's good. That's good to
it's
know.
All about the heights.
I feel like I can use that at a later date.
Yes.
I'm going to remember that.
And that's why I don't snow ski.
Got it. Got it.
I can do the bunny hill with the pole rope.
I was just going to say, you can do the pole rope.
Yeah, but that's the pole rope. After.
Yeah. Very good. Michael Walker, what's up, guys, from Rednecks RS Outdoors in Fort Worth, Texas.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, guys. Let's see. Oh, we've got lots of hats. Everybody wants these hats.
This thing is going to be the one. The one cool thing about these, I know we're giving a few of them away, but probably in the next couple weeks, they'll be on the Excel page.
On the Excel store where you can buy them there.
Yep. You'll be able to buy those there. So
yeah.
They're not quite there yet. They're here in Utah. We just had them all put together with the Excel logo and stuff on them. And they will be shortly heading to Mountain View, Arkansas.
The plant in Arkansas is where they'll be.
They'll ship them out from there.
They do all our shipping.
I'm going to have to make sure I have one of those myself. But don't tell Dave.
Don't tell Dave. Seriously. Casey James Brady, are you guys going to the Youth Waterfowl Fair this Saturday in Farmington? We are not. I'm so sorry. We really should be, and it didn't work out for us this year, and we're really sad we're not going to be there. But Casey, I think maybe you should, represent.
And it's a great cause. I went out there, quite a few years ago with my Morgan.
Yeah.
And we were out there. Clint was out there with one of the boats and motors. And,
yes.
We got to go ride around in an airboat, which I had never done, and she hadn't either. Then we jump on a mud boat, and it's the only mud motor there that's not a Mud Buddy. And I have to ride
it. And you got
to
ride it.
But I am representing because I got my Mud Buddy shirt, my Mud Buddy hat. And the guy's like, so you like Mud Buddy? I'm like, I work at Mud Buddy.
At Mud Buddy.
I said, it's not a bad little rig, I didn't want to say anything.
That's
but
nice.
It's a great event for the kids because they've got dog trainers there showing them what the dogs can do. The first so many people get...
Yes.
Calls, so it's just a great little event here for Utah to get the younger kids excited about waterfowling.
Yes,
but
absolutely.
No, we won't be there because it's going to be hot.
So hot, oh man. Mark Harrell says thank you for all the help and work you did for him.
You're welcome, Mark. That's what I'm here for. I try my best, and
literally is the only reason you're here.
Yes. No, because I have responsibilities.
Got it. You do have responsibility. Very responsible. Joe DeCrane is trying to stick up for you, too. He says 100 is the new 30.
Yeah, that's a good one. Appreciate that. I'm not quite 100.
You're 100.
Jeff. I'm more than halfway there, that's for sure.
Yeah. Chris Kinder asks, what does the 3-blade give you over the 2-blade? Which is a really great question. Overall information that everybody always
needs. It's basically going to give you more mid-range and upper-end speeds. Coming out of the hole, it's not quite with the big blade or in the mud, but a little bit deeper water, you'll move. It'll move faster than a big blade and the hammer.
Right.
So, it's kind of a...
More of a top speed, less of a dig.
If you're pushing really heavy loads... Probably not the best prop in the world to run, but there's some rumors going around town, and that's all I'm going to say, that there's some other stuff coming down the road.
Wow.
And that may be, I can't say.
You were very bold.
I'm very bold. Be in trouble.
You were in trouble.
Don't tell
anybody.
Yes, that's our little
That
secret.
Is not a rumor. That's not even a rumor. That didn't even happen. Matt Cow asks for it because he won this hat. He wants a close-up of the hat.
A close-up.
So that's what it looks like there, and then it's a mesh back, and it's got the XL patch on the side.
These and that's the Optifade Marsh pattern.
Optifade Marsh.
Optifade Marsh.
Absolutely.
So for you guys who hung on the Marsh, a great hat. We have this style in the timber. I think we do, but they're not back from the printer.
No, we've got lots of new hats coming out from Mud Buddy. We've got some solid colored ones coming out that are really awesome. We've got... and then more of the timber and the Optifade coming as well, which will have actually a new, slightly updated logo on it, which is awesome.
That.
Yeah.
I'll have to get one of those too.
I know. These are the things that I work on. My responsibility.
Your responsibility.
Yeah.
Yours sounds like more fun.
It is. No, it totally is. Michael Walker, what would be a good motor for my 14-foot flat-bottom Kingfisher looking for something that's not your phone? It's just the absolute worst.
Oh, it was a good phone a couple weeks ago.
Oh my gosh. It's cut off, and every time I click, this is just ridiculous.
Well, still
looking
Rick
for something that
just
is not.
Looking at his.
That
Turn
is
that
not,
thing off.
Oh my goodness.
So, what would be a good boat for that? Either a long tail or the minis would be good.
Okay.
They're designed for smaller size boats.
Right.
Mini would be a good one. I like the minis.
I do too. We've said it.
We've run it quite a few times. The local guy that I hunt with here a lot, Clint, our sales guy, he's got one on his little XL, and that little 23 with the two of us good-sized boys in there, it still moves pretty good with that heavy little XL 1544. Still scoop pretty good. So that would be a good one. Either, either the little surface drive or the long tail would be good for that size boat.
Very good. Chris Rockwell asked, what is the best prop in y'all's opinion for the Sport V carbureted?
Carbureted, if you're having vibration issues, you want to go with the Mercury 3 blade.
Right.
That will help off balance, counter some of the vibrations between the transmission and the prop, a harmonic type of thing that goes on there. The other one, it would be a big blade. And if you've got a big, you know, like a 50 or a 5,000 or a 6,000 or a 7,000, some of those older motors, the hammer would be a good one. That's a little bit bigger than the big blade.
Michael Walker, will you guys be coming to Marshfest in Winnie, Texas in March? Well, we are now.
That sounds like it. Can you make that happen?
Yes. I'm not going to rule anything out at this point.
I would love to be there. Now if we can just swing it on company dime.
Absolutely. No, that actually sounds fun. We do want to get out a little more, especially now that season 2 is about to start. Season 2 of Shallow Water Adventures with Keith and Jeffrey.
On location.
On location.
There we go.
Exactly. See, so who knows what's going to happen. Wesley Boyd says Matt Cowell is going out tonight. Oh, yes. Yes, all of these. There are some good names coming in.
We'll throw
guys.
A couple at us. Come on, quit just hiding them.
You want me to share some of these?
Yeah, share a couple.
Well, I mean, I don't want to show favoritism or anything.
Well, yeah, I'm not. Just kind of just close your eyes, roll, and pick one.
All right.
Maybe not when you scroll too hard because it's an old phone.
Just break this stupid phone.
As long as Mud Buddy will buy a new one, I'm all for it.
Swamp Buggy?
Swamp Buggy.
I kind of like. Mud Buddy Soaring Eagle?
Marsh Assassinator?
Marsh Assassinator. That's a good one. Freddy would like that one. Well, maybe the old one.
No, there's some really good ones. Killing Time. I love the Bandit. The Adventurer. There are a lot. Swamp Thing.
Swamp Thing?
Swamp Thing. Kind of like it, man. There are some good ones in here. But keep those coming.
Yes. We're going to have probably a couple people join us as we roll through those and pick like the top 10 or 15 and whittle it down from there to get to number one.
Yeah, to number one.
Maybe we should find number one out here.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen.
Jeff Warner, everyone talks about pushing a heavy load or hull. What would you consider a heavy load or hull?
Anything more than what your boat's rated for.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, most boats are so many pounds or so many people, and every marsh that I've been to, everybody's overloaded. So pushing heavy load is more than what your boat's really set up to haul, which is most boats are two, maybe three guys, and probably 400 to 600, 700 pounds. So,
and that will vary. I mean, it really depends on the boat.
It does,
right?
And look on that little placard in your boat. It will tell you what your weight limit is, what your people is. I had a guy last year call me, and I wish I could remember what school he went to. Had a big boat, a good motor, but it just wasn't getting up on step very fast. So the first question I ask is like, well, how many guys do you hunt with, and what's your size? And he says, well, there's three of us. I was like, okay, that's not too bad.
It's not too bad.
He says, two of us are offensive linemen, and my other friend's a defensive lineman. So we're all well over 300
pounds.
I'm like, yeah, and that's why you're having a little bit of an issue with getting it up on step.
You might need a little more.
Probably close to 1,000 pounds on no decoys, no guns, no cooler, nothing. Just three good old boys in their duck boat. And it's power to weight. If you got too much weight, you got to have a lot of power.
Absolutely. Got to have the power.
And if you need power, call my buddy Travis and Corbin and Glade over at Backwater.
At Backwater Performance.
They can help you out with a little bit more power. And if you have questions, feel free to reach out to Mud Buddy at 801-352-8011. Got him on that one. And ask Alicia if she can hook you up with Micah.
Yes.
Micah can help you with some of those parts. And if you have performance questions, what would help you push a bigger load, what's good for you, and the type of hunting in the areas that you need and those kind of loads.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. They'll have so much information, be able to really hook you up. It's the look in your face when you say the number that it's almost like you have to read it.
I know it, but I'm thinking as I'm like,
I know.
I need to write it.
It just makes me laugh. It's like, yeah, and call us at 801. That's my Keith impression. You're welcome, everybody. Anthony Trammell, best blind setup for an 1860 Pro Hull. I don't have any info on this one for you, Anthony.
Here, where we're at, it's all fast grass.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to say the guys over at Backwater, because I know their product. I haven't seen any other ones. I have seen an Avery one. It was a nice setup.
Okay.
But here in Utah, it's definitely fast grass because you're in the cattails and the Phragmites.
Absolutely. Yeah, so but BPS is going to be a really good resource for you, Anthony.
And they've got the fast grass and the other one, I can't remember. That's really good.
Okay, Todd Hurley, I need... Todd Hurley, it looks like you wrote to me in another language. And 44, when rolling in my... So I need clarification on that. I want to answer that question because I don't know what that means. Take a look at that. And I think that's about it. I'm kind of running to the end there. So again, I apologize for the technical difficulties for everybody who wrote questions on the earlier post. We're going to go through that and answer all the questions on this post. We will just kind of go and find those and repost. We will.
Okay.
You will. When I say we, I mean
you. I was kind of thinking. It's like,
yeah,
you're using that word kind of.
We're on the same page. We know what we're talking about.
We're team.
Yeah.
Team. But we haven't given our other hat away. Okay. Just randomly pick some guy, or person, or individual.
Let me find. It was Taylor, whose boyfriend just got the brand new.
Oh, there you go. Now, Taylor, you know what? I noticed something when we Taylor say PMSS. Hoover. It sounds like we're saying PMS. So PM us.
Private messages.
Because
your information.
My wife and I were watching it last week. She wanted to watch and she's like, are you guys saying PMSS? And I'm like, no, we're saying PMS.
PMS.
Yes. So we'll have to watch that. Because she's an English type of person, so she's always...
Taylor Hoover, PM me or Keith your information, your address, and whatnot. So, and we'll get that hat sent out to you. That's this hat right here.
Because we want your man styling.
Yes, he's got a new boat coming. He's gonna be set, ready to go. All right, I think that's it. So again, for all of you watching on Facebook Live, make sure that you are following Mud Buddies page, and you can hit the little bell on the side of the page. That will give you a notification every time we go live. A little notification will pop up. You'll never miss a single moment or a single episode. For those of you watching on YouTube later, the same thing. Hit subscribe, follow us on YouTube. We'll be posting all of the videos on there as they come out.
And make sure you share this with your friends.
And share.
Some of your friends probably aren't out there able to watch us, but
yeah,
they'll appreciate you sharing.
They will appreciate
Jeff and
it.
Keith with them.
Because of all this. All right. I think that's it, Keith.
Should we give one more shout-out to our soon-to-be, up-and-coming...
We should. That's good idea.
I mean, we can't thank them enough.
We really can't thank them enough. These are the ones that make this show possible. Without them, we don't get to give away all these amazing prizes. We don't get to be here screwing around all day and having a good time. So,
say that.
So we really do appreciate them. Tangle Free, the t-shirt that I'm wearing... thank you so much for the gear. They've got a ton of stuff coming for you. So Tangle Free, we love them. Thank you so much. Echo Calls,
Rick Dunn and the boys.
Yeah.
We've got 12 calls, and we've got some Mallard Madness with Freddie and the Echo Boys. And those are really good videos to watch.
Really great stuff. Lucky Duck has sent some stuff. They've actually sent some...
They sent some really cool stuff.
Some really cool stuff. I was about to say what it is, but I'm not going to tell you.
You have one, but you
I do have one. Deep Apparel has sent some cool stuff that we're really excited about.
Like,
I know
that stuff.
They've got some cool
stuff
coming in.
They've got some really wonderful colors, and there's one of them. If Ambry's not here tomorrow, it may just go home with Keith over the weekend.
It's gonna get stolen. Swiftwater, we've got a really big prize from Camp Chef.
Camp Chef's hooking us up. Ryan and the boys at a local little company up the hill in Logan.
I might quit the show just so I can get that one. Honestly, that's the one I really...
And I think we need to get Ryan to come down.
No, we do. Well,
and we need to hit the marsh.
Last year, he came twice.
Yeah,
we got him twice.
I mean, we need to be cooking in the marsh.
Yeah. Yes.
Maybe get up real early, get out there, and have him whip up some breakfast.
So here's another thing that I wanted to... Before we go, send us your suggestions of things that you would like us to go, places to go, things to see... I mean, everybody's like, come on out to Texas, come over here. We want to. We want to do all of that. But if there's other things you want us to see, certain performance issues that you're having that we need to explain better, or if you want to see Keith try and shoot a shotgun, or catch a fish, can even do
it. I can shoot a gun. Fishing's different.
So all of those suggestions, send those in too. So we love to look at those, and it'll make this whole new season even more fun having your suggestions. So so send those in. And then, of course, our last sponsor, BPS, are good. I mean, they've got some really great stuff coming.
They're fun guys to hang with.
Oh, yeah.
I'm looking forward to...
We're going to be doing several episodes with
ice
guys.
Fishing.
Oh, yeah.
That was hilarious and a lot of fun. Really late nights. Hard to get up in the morning, but...
It gets a little late. All right. So we're going to end it right there. We've been on a while. Thank you, everybody, so much for watching. We really appreciate it. One more big shout-out to Jody, our fearless camera woman, who is about to pass out because she's been standing there for about an hour now. Thank you so much. And thank you all for watching. Tune in 2 weeks, September 20th, for the premiere episode of Season 2, The Shallow Water Adventure. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you then.